don't know. I thank you for this gift. I didn't expect a gift, but thank you. I don't know this book.
It's one of my favorite books, and I'd like to actually have a thank you note myself. Just to, I'd like to thank you notes for meaning that I don't have to follow Seth Rogen and James Franco and Stevie Wonder.
How great are those guys?
Feels like a moment.
Dude, I was like, I didn't know what to expect.
I was watching it. It was so crazy, and I'm watching it, and I'm thinking to myself, how the hell do I walk out?
That was pretty crazy. Dude, last time you were on the show, I want to say it was 6 months ago, and gosh, you've done so much since then. Yeah. You've done Avengers Age of Ultron, and you are actually Ultron.
I'm Ultron.
Yeah. You're the big villain. I mean, and then you had to go to Comic-Con.
8-foot robot.
That's all right. So that's correct. And then you went to Comic-Con and to promote it.
We finished the season of Blacklist, and 2 days later, I got on a plane, flew to London to shoot the Avengers. And then wrapped that, came back here to New York, and flew immediately to Comic-Con, and then flew back from Comic-Con to start shooting the second season of Blacklist.
Wow.
And it was crazy.
That was
I mean, but Comic-Con is the most insane. Have any of you ever been to Comic-Con in San Diego?
Yeah, I have. I've been.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
You brave, brave souls.
It's exciting, isn't it fun?
It is crazy.
Yeah, it really is.
I mean, life really can't get strange enough for me, but I mean, it is the craziest place I have ever been.
Yeah, because there are just ultimate fans just going out to just be
fans. Well, yeah, and you're, you know, and in such a concentrated group, you know, you're in a room with thousands of people, and I've spent my life going out to live music, going to rock concerts, going to jazz, and, you know, I mean, just going to all kinds of, you know, live music and live performance. But it's so different, you know, because the moment that, like, the band hits the stage, it's like a release already. And then it's just, throughout a concert, you know, it's just like sort of multiple orgasmic experience culminating in this sort of tantric climax, you know, the end of it. But it's a release, you know.
Yeah.
And Comic-Con.
I was gonna say, you've seen me live.
Yeah,
very nice. Yeah.
And but Comic-Con, it's all anticipation. I mean, they're not getting a performance in any way, shape, or form.
You just get to see people. Really.
It's a tease, you know, because it's all anticipatory. It's like foreplay for hours and days. I mean, it's 3 days.
3 days of foreplay.
Of foreplay.
Yeah, very.
But what you don't realize is that it's not like, okay, at the end of the 3 days, you get that, you know, it's going to happen. You know, they're anticipating an event that's not going to happen for 6 months or a year.
It's really torturous for them, yeah.
I can't imagine.
Would they put themselves through that? Yeah, they really hype themselves up.
I can imagine them going back to the hotel after, like, the full day of, like, you know, they're just in a lather. I mean, I think you can get back to the hotel and, like, have to take a cold shower and, like... I mean...
And none of that, no.
And you can feel it. It's like, you know, blood coursing. You can hear it.
Okay. In the all right, yeah, here we go. Yeah, we got it now. We see where it goes.
Just like tonight.
Yeah, I want to talk to... Yeah, it is like tonight. But I want to... you can feel it in the air. But we're going to go all the way tonight, James. Here we go. This is...
Okay. We're going to reach that tantric climax.
Yeah, this is New York City. We know how to do it right now. Thank you for watching, and as a thank you, I'm now going to do something I've never done before. Juggle. Not looking. Now knives. Ah! Oh! Oh! Oh, dear. Dear Moses. Dear Moses.